Hello guys, today I am going to tell you about Olber's paradox. It named after the German astronomer Heinrich Wilhelm Olbers. This paradox argues about why we see the night sky so dark even we are having billions of stars in our night sky. Have you might wondered why the sky is blue or what gives sunset their brilliant red? These bright colors stick out in the natural world and beg for an explanation. But have you ever might wondered why the night sky is black? The question barely makes sense the first time you hear it. It's like asking why is water wet? But for centuries, the darkness of the night sky had astronomers stumped. They called the puzzle as the Olber's paradox. Distant stars look weak and very distant stars shine too dimly for you to see with your eyes. But when space telescope like Hubble peer deep into the darkest spot of the sky, they uncover bunches of incredibly faint galaxies. And the deeper they look, the more they find. If the universe went on forever with stars sprinkled evenly throughout, as many early stargazers assumed, the night sky would be full of so many points of light that it would never look dark. The fact that the stars are everywhere makes up for the fact that some of the stars are far away. No matter which way you look in an endless universe, your line of sight would always end on the surface of a star, and the entire sky would always blaze with the brightness of the sun. The fact that the night exists at all proves that the stars we see don't go on forever. To understand why, think about how light rays travel from a faraway stars to your eyes. Like people and cars, light has a speed, so even though it moves very fast, it still takes time to arrive at its destination. When you get a postcard from a friend on a vacation, you learn what they were doing last week when they sent it, not what they are doing the moment you read it. When you look at a planet, star or galaxy, you are also receiving a message from a past, a message that tells you what the bright object was doing at the moment it sent the light to you. When you look at a sun indirectly, of course you are seeing the light it emitted 8 minutes ago. Jupiter appears that it was at least half an hour ago. Your journey into the past speeds up as you look past our solar system. Light from the second closest star after the sun takes more than 4 years to reach Earth, and the spotting the most distant star visible to the eye takes you back 4000 years. When astronomers study the neighboring Andromeda galaxy, they see it as it was 2.5 million years ago. If a cosmic disaster somehow erased it tomorrow, light wouldn't carry the message to Earth for another 2.5 million years. The farther out into the universe you look, the farther back in time you see. Cosmologists are really lucky. They can see the entire history of the universe laid out in a nice line. The mystery of the dark sky is solved by the fact that this history has a beginning, a time before stars and galaxies. Many cosmologists think the universe started out as a very small point and then started inflating like a balloon in an event called the Big Bang. If you look deep enough, you can see so far back in time that you get close to the Big Bang and you ran out of stars in a grand scheme of things relatively quickly. Cosmologists call this early era the cosmic dark ages. During this time, space was, as you can probably guess, pretty dark. Stars were just starting to burn and a thick fog of hydrogen gas blocked the lights. No matter how good your eyesight, and the upcoming James Webb telescope will have a sharp peep indeed. When you look back this far, there is just not much to see. When you look up at the starry sky, the darkness you see is in the some sense the darkness leftovers from the early era. Stars do not light up the entire sky because the part of the universe that we can see has a finite size. It does not go on forever, as the early astronomers thought. There is not enough light to fill in all the gaps. There is also an alternative explanation of Olber's paradox with the help of steady state theory, which says we have missed something, that's why we can't explain darkness of night sky. Steady state theory is based on the assumption that universe is not expanding. So that means that the light waves traveling to us from that stars would stay at the same wavelength as they reached us. Moreover, if the universe was infinitely old, then the light from stars at extremely far distances would have already reached us, even if they were 40 billion light years away. Remember, in this scenario, the distance between us and the stars does not matter because we are assuming universe is infinitely old. So what does all this mean? Well, we just proved that according to steady state theory and a little common sense, we should be able to see a star anywhere in the night sky, and so the sky should have the same brightness everywhere. But as you all know, if you look at the sky at night, it's dark and speckled with bright points of light called the stars. How can this be explained? Something seemed to be amiss. Probing the farthest and the oldest part of the universe usually takes years of research and powerful telescopes, but the night sky has been dangling the answer to one fundamental question right before our eyes the whole time. All you have to do is go and look at the space between the stars. So guys, that's all for today. If you learned something new, then please like and subscribe my channel. You can also watch my other videos which are displaying on your screen on Zero Point Energy, a key for time travel. And on Mars, we have found a lake full of water in the form of ice and many more. So guys, go and check out those videos. And once again, thank you for watching.